The right work can be satisfying for other reasons besides compensation.
It's funny, with all the technology and all the different alien cultures, this is still the part that newcomers always have the hardest time adapting to.
Welcome everybody at the second episode of Zeit-Talks. My name is Case and I'm your goofy co-pilot on the Starship Enterprise and the Orville this time instead of Starship Earth. In the previous episode, I was talking about a thought exercise and I would like to continue on that. So in the previous episode, I talked about how powerless we feel in the present to influence the future. But if we were able to time travel back to the past, we would know exactly what to do to influence the future, because we then have a better understanding about the world. That's why I suggested to sign up on this forum, where you can connect with people on a local level and continue this thought exercise as well, but also continue discussions with people about where we are now and where we could be going as a human society. So what kind of problems do we have and what kind of existing solutions could we already implement, or what kind of trends are there where we can move forward? But in this episode, I would like to talk about an episode from Star Trek The Next Generation. And that episode shows a culture shock from people from the 24th century meeting people from the 20th century. These people come from a recovered space capsule, and these people were in hibernation for a few centuries. And suddenly they wake up in a total different environment where there's a different economy and a different culture built around it. But they still show the old 20th century cultural zeitgeist, so to speak. So they are very arrogant, they are impatient, they also still have signs of alcoholism to escape reality. They also feel entitled. So especially compared to the culture from the Enterprise crew, which shows a more mature and more understanding posture and attitude. They try to reason with them. They try to slowly integrate them into this new culture. But you can really can see the culture shock and the resistance going on, because they have such a cultural baggage to adapt to this new culture. So let's have a look.
There was marked deterioration in every system of his body, probably from massive chemical abuse. Unbelievable.
Sounds like someone who hated life. Yet he had himself frozen, presumably, so he could go through it all again.
Too afraid to live, too scared to die.
You are on the starship USS Enterprise.
American?
No, it's a vessel in the United Federation of Planets, and Earth is a member.
And the liver that was about to explode in my face?
Perfectly sound.
I need to make a phone call as soon as possible.
A phone call?
Yes, I have provided for myself. I have a substantial portfolio, and it's critical that I check on it. Let the bank know that I'm alive, and well.
It's gonna be a little difficult right at the moment.
Well, do you at least have a copy of the Wall Street Journal?
I think we should take the doctor's advice. Take this very slowly until we've all adjusted, and then we'll talk to the captain.
I have to phone Geneva right away about my accounts. Why, the interest alone could be enough to buy this ship.
They are the most unusual humans I have ever encountered.
Well, from what I've seen of our guests, there's not much to redeem them. Makes one wonder how our species survived the 21st century.
I'm Captain Picard.
Excellent. Now maybe we'll be able to get some things straightened out.
We may indeed. Those comm panels are for official ship business.
Well, if they're so important, why don't they need an executive key?
Aboard a starship vessel, that is not necessary. We are all capable of exercising self-discipline now. You will refrain from using them.
Now, just a minute.
We are in a very serious and potentially dangerous situation.
Well, I'm sure whatever it is seems very important to you. But my situation is far more critical.
I don't think you are aware your situation, or of how much time has passed.
Believe me, I am fully cognizant of where I am and when. It is simply that I have more to protect than a man in your position could possibly imagine. No offense, Matt, but a military career has never been considered to be upwardly mobile. I must contact my lawyer.
Your lawyer has been dead for centuries.
Yes, of course I know that. But he was a full partner in a very important firm. Rest assured, that firm is still operating.
That's what all this is about. A lot has changed in the past 300 years. People are no longer obsessed with the accumulation of things. We have eliminated hunger, want, the need for possessions. We've grown out of our infancy.
Captain, I didn't mean to come on so strong. It's just that I've built my whole life on knowing what's going on. And for the first time, I feel completely out of touch. It's making me crazy. You can understand that.
That's the first thing you said. I do understand.
It's a pity we can't take them there ourselves. Having them on board is like a visit from the past.
That would take us in the wrong direction. Our mission is to go forward. And it's just begun. Set velocity. Warp 6, Mr. LaForge.
Aye, sir. Warp 6.
There's still much to do. Still so much to learn.
So, now let's have a look at the Orville episode. So in this episode, a person requests asylum on board of the Orville because her planet is suffering from an out-of-control cancel culture, where people microanalyze each other's behavior and likes and dislikes have real-world consequences. She wants to escape from that, so she boards the Orville to start a new life. But she finds it difficult to find her meaning there because there's a different economy in place and different culture built around it. Let's have a look.
So wait, if nobody has to have a job, then why do you guys all work?
The right work can be satisfying for other reasons besides compensation.
It's funny, with all the technology and all the different alien cultures, this is still the part that newcomers always have the hardest time adapting to.
I mean, it's just so basic. You have a job, you survive. If you don't, you starve.
It used to be that way on Earth, too, until the invention of the matter synthesizer. It was the single most transformative moment in our history. When all your material needs are provided for at no cost, it changes the entire game.
So then, why don't you guys just lay around all day and do nothing?
Well, it's sort of frowned upon socially. But more important than that, it's no fun. See, on your planet, currency is money. In the Union, it's reputation. So if you do something, anything that benefits our society, and you work hard at it, you're rich. And that could be anything, from being a great scientist, or a great doctor, a great chef, or a great waiter. It's all valued.
That's amazing.
Or maybe you want to study a field of research. Learn all you can about history, physics, literature, or art, just for your own pleasure. That's a respected life, too. The only life considered poor is one that's wasted on apathy.
So I can do anything I want.
Yep.
So I show these scenes as thought exercises. They're fiction, it's no real proof of anything, but it does show you how difficult cultural change can be. I think everyone would agree on that. But how does this exactly relate to the Zeitgeist movement? So the Zeitgeist movement is working to change the dominant culture and social climate of our time, hence the name Zeitgeist. We are an educational movement that aims to achieve sustainable social change. A shift in our social values is crucial for this. A society that operates under the assumption that we can ignore our ecosystem in our decisions is harmful. Sustainable technology in the hands of such a society has limited success, especially when our society is not aware of the utopia to maintain an infinite growth economy on a planet that does not have infinite resources. Without well-founded social and sustainability values, science and technology may not be used optimally. For example, splitting the atom could have remained with the possibility of generating a lot of energy with less. But now our planet is littered with the most deadly weapons ever. As the world craves more Manhattan projects, not to make more weapons of mass destruction, but mass creation projects to make the world a better place. Without positive cultural and economic change, the next Manhattan project may be even more damaging to human society. It can be compared to a child who finds his father's gone. As a society, we are not yet mature enough to handle this responsibility. So, it's basically about a revolution of ideas. Otherwise, we could build the cities as designed by Jacques Vesco from the Venus Project, but we don't have the value system to support and maintain such a city. You can basically compare it to bringing Native Americans and put them in downtown New York City and expect them to find a job and an apartment. It doesn't work like that. They don't have the value system to support and maintain a city like that. That is why the Zeitgeist movement is focusing on this educational change to support and soften the blow of the culture shock that is coming this century. Anyway, so that was it for this episode. Join the discussion at tcm.one, or if you're Dutch, go to zeitgeistbeweging.nl, and see you in the next episode.